Happy Thursday night, everyone. Welcome to our Broadway Flops Cabaret. My name is Tabitha Jablonski, and today we are going to be singing songs from shows that lasted less than a year on Broadway, but we love them anyway. There are some incredible shows where you realize that they just weren't appreciated, or even if you're like, eh, that show wasn't that good, the music's amazing, or there's definitely things that need to be mentioned about these shows. And I'm just so excited to explore some of Broadway's most underrated works with everybody. I am so excited to introduce our host for this evening. He has been in a bunch of our readings. Most recently, he was in our reading of Cabaret, and he's been in Guys and Dolls and a whole bunch, and I'm really excited. He's a really fun guy, and he's been in a lot of our cabarets and blown us all away with his music and his singing abilities. So please welcome to the virtual stage, Stephen Yednock.
Hey, thank you, Tabitha. That was very nice of you to say. So we are doing our cabaret this evening on Broadway Flops. So we're going to start off with Michelle Moses Eisenstein, who was recently seen singing Moonfall for our 80s party cabaret. I actually know Michelle at least a little bit before the end times started. She actually saw me in a show that I was in. And she also, she knows the person I know, Bob Yuzakis. Can we welcome to the stage Michelle Moses Eisenstein?
Hi, everyone. Thanks for joining us, Stephen. And yeah, I had the treat of seeing you in Guys and Dolls in regular life, and then we got to do it
in real space and with stage and costumes and all those things. So, yeah, remember those times? Yeah. So you're going to sing for us something from The Great Comet of 1812. And I'm going to confess, I don't know very much about this show, except I think Josh Groban was involved. Is that correct?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know.
Tell me a little bit more.
Sure. So, yeah, I know that he and Philippa Sue and I have to go back to my notes. I'm not sure how her name was pronounced, but...
It's good you have notes.
Deanie Benton, who I think she's my favorite for the female lead. They got great reviews for the show, and for whatever reason, it was on Broadway less than a year. It closed after 336 performances, but it's got really great music, and so tonight I'm happy to sing one of the arias from the show that's called No One Else. And I never saw
a great job in the other cabarets that I've seen you in here. So I'm looking forward to hearing this song tonight.
Great. Well, thank you. So yeah, this is No One Else.
So I'll leave it to you, Michelle Moses Eisenstein.
Childlike eyes and your distant and smile. We'll never be this happy again, you and I, and no one else. We've done so before, we were angels once, don't you remember? Joy and light inside our souls, and nobody knows, just you and me. It's our secret. This winter sky, how can anyone sleep? There was never such a night before. I feel like wrapping my arms around my knees and squeezing tight as possible and flying away. Like this. Childlike eyes and your distant smile. Oh, never be this happy again, you and I, you and I, you and I. And no. Simply forgot. Thank you.
Always miss turning on the mic again. That was beautiful, Michelle. Thank you so much. That was a beautiful song. So I don't understand why that was a flop. With such a beautiful song there, but moving on, we are now bringing back to the stage the person that started this whole theater company and who is an awesome performer and an awesome person, Tabitha Jablonski.
Thank you.
Tabitha, most recently, she's done a lot of stuff, okay? I mean, come on. Come on, if you've been watching these cabarets, you've seen her do lots of songs, excellently. But most recently, she was singing Come Out of the Dumpster from The Wedding Singer.
That's what I'm singing tonight.
Oh, whoops. Uh-oh, I'm reading the wrong thing. Man. So I've just told you what she's going to sing. There you go. Okay. Take it away, Tabitha.
Thank you. So this is from The Wedding Singer. We did this in our group a couple, maybe a month ago, a little bit more than that. And I think this group did an incredible job. It was such a fun show to do, even virtually. Just if you guys don't know it, it's the musical version of the 19, I think the movie came out in the 90s, but it takes place in the 80s. And it's the Adam Sandler's version movie with Drew Barrymore, The Wedding Singer. And I actually saw the original Broadway cast on Broadway when I was 13, which is funny. It was like a field trip for theater kids. But looking back, like that show, it's not the most appropriate thing for younger kids. And it was a lot of 80s references that I didn't understand at the time. But even 13-year-old me loved this show, loved the soundtrack. soundtrack, and I remember being sad that like it didn't get any love in the Tonys, and it lasted, I think it was like it lasted from like spring to winter of the same year, so it was a lot less than a year. But I really like it. I've seen it a couple times with community theaters, and I just think it's a fun show that is a little underrated. And it had Laura Benanti, and I know Constantine Maroulis was in it later on, so yeah, it has a cool history. And if you don't know of the story, this song takes place after Robbie, who's the main character. He's a wedding singer that just got stood up in his own wedding, and he has to go back to work, and he's really depressed, and he ends up making a fool of himself, being all depressed and ruining a wedding, and then he ends up in a dumpster. So this is Julia's character singing to him to try to get him out of the dumpster. So tonight you made some mistakes. I'll admit, you hit a few bumps. But I hate to see you like this, down on your luck, down in the dumps. Though hope might seem in short supply, you have to move on. You have to try. So come out of the dumpster. Don't leave me standing here. Come out of the dumpster. It's okay, the coast is clear. The cop cars are leaving. Channel 5's packed up its crew. So come out of the dumpster. I'll be right here waiting for you. So you're back in the dumpster. Well, that's like a metaphor. Everyone has a dumpster, a stumbling block they can't ignore. But to fight it makes you stronger, and next time you might stand. So come out of the dumpster. Here, take a hold of my hand. So your first day back wasn't all you anticipated. You bit the best man, the bride had to be sedated. This sort of thing happens all the time. When life gives you garbage, you use it to climb. Look! You're out of the dumpster. Was that so hard after all? It was only a dumpster. And from here it looks so small. So you're back where you started, on your way to success. So will you sing at my wedding? Thank you.
Man, just, you know, beautiful song, and then they rejection right at the end. I'm sorry, Tabitha. But beautiful singing. Thank you very much, Tabitha Jablonski. So we are now going to ask Alexandra Fay to join us. Alexandra, hey, was last seen performing When I Look at You for a Robbed Cafe, Cabaret. Alexandra was also Lieutenant Brannigan in The Guys and Dolls. Yeah, with the mustache. Oh yeah, man, the mustache was great. Oh yeah. So I feel like I sort of performed with you, and the same thing for Michelle Moses Eisenstein, who was also in Guys and Dolls. So yeah. These online shows, you feel like you've performed with people, Really not, and it's so weird.
Surreal.
It is a little surreal, but it's still theater down
here. Yeah, it is, and it's a wonderful feeling. You still get that magical feeling.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. You still have that contact high exactly. After doing the show. So that's
former high, yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
so Alexander, what are you going to share with us tonight?
I'm doing a song from, I actually didn't know this was a musical, American Psycho. It's called A Girl Before. I love the movie. And so I just looked up songs from there and found one and was like, okay. And it lasted like a month on Broadway, but
wow,
still love the movie.
I should see the movie, but I'm just curious if they have a whole montage song dedicated to the Huey Lewis in the News.
Yes, apparently they do.
They do. Now I'm going to look this up.
Okay. Yeah. All right, but this isn't it. But this song isn't it, but it'll be good, hopefully.
I will leave it to you, Alexandra.
Thank you. Here we go.
He doesn't sound all right, his voice a little thin. Does he need someone the way that I need him? Does everything he has amount to enough? Does he need someone to hold when it gets rough? Am I someone he could linger on? Or would he simply move along? Am I someone he would? Girl before, a girl before. He looks at me sometimes in a certain way. All the fears I have seem to fade away. I know that I'm a fool to think that this is real. I'm breaking every rule, 'cause this is how I feel. Am I someone he could linger on? Or would he simply move along? Am I someone he could girl before, a girl before, a girl before, a girl before.
Thank you. Thanks.
It was haunting.
Ooh, thank you. Kind of song. Now I want to see the musical, right?
Yeah. Even with the Huey Lewis in the News sequence. I'm imagining, I'm trying to picture it in my head. And shower curtains. I don't know much about that movie. I need to see
it. Me neither. Yeah. She's a secretary. I don't know. Thank you, Steve. You're doing a great job. Steven or Steve?
Hey, thanks. Thank you, Alex.
Do you have Steve or Steven? I'm sorry.
I will, I'll take either one. So.
Okay. Steven. Okay, cool. See you. Check you later.
Okay. So we are now going to welcome Brittany Washington to the stage. This is Brittany's first time at No Place Like Home Cabaret.
Yay!
So everyone, welcome Brittany in your own home. Welcome her into your homes so that she can grace us with the beauty and wondrousness of her.
Well, I am so excited to be here, so.
Excellent. Brittany, what are you going to sing for us tonight?
I'm going to be singing a song called How About a Dance from the musical Bonnie and Clyde. It lasted all of 36 performances on Broadway, but wow. It had Laura Osnes before she was Laura Osnes and Jeremy Jordan before he was Jeremy Jordan.
So, oh, hello.
You know, good cast, great show, but the music's fun. So,
well, looking forward to hearing from Bonnie and Clyde. And take it away, Brittany.
Thank you.
How about a dance? What do you say? I've got some moves that I'd love to show ya. Let's find a spot and dance the night away. How about a dance? It's always fun. Come over here, let me get to know ya. Can't beat a band to lift your spirits high. You look so handsome. How about a dance? Let's make a start. Music like this can really thrill ya. You lose the blues and you may lose your heart. Tonight is the night I've been waiting for. Even the moon looks just right. I'm sure the crowd would make room on the floor. When they see you look like you do, so how about a dance? Let's make a start. Music like this can really throw ya. You lose the blues and you may lose your heart. You'll lose the blues and you may lose your heart.
Thanks, guys.
Woo! Brittany, why did you wait so long to join us? Oh, man, that was beautiful. Thank you very much, Brittany Washington, for singing How About a Dance from Bonnie and Clyde. I'm going to try doing this. Let's see if I can have my co-host here, Muggsy. I don't know if he's going to be cooperative or not, but oh, there we go. So. Hey, Muggsy, we're doing Broadway flops tonight. Did you know that? Muggsy did not know that. But You're a pretty good co-host, right? Yeah, he's pretty good. Okay. working with kids and animals. There you go. Okay. I'm going to, oh, floppy ears for Broadway Flops. Nice, clever, there we go. I'm gonna now welcome to the stage, Colin Willis. Colin was last seen performing The Next Right Thing for our Disney Cabaret.
I'm sorry, she's not here right now.
Oh no, okay, well.
We'll just skip to Hannah.
Hopefully we'll be able to come back to Colin maybe sometime later. But for now, we're going to go to Hannah Butler, who was last seen performing Can't Help Falling in Love for our 60s cabaret. Hey, hello.
Hello.
Muggsy says hello.
Hi, Muggsy.
Hi. What are you gracing us with us tonight, Hannah?
So I am singing Once More I Can See from the musical Wonderland. Didn't last very long on Broadway. It kind of received some really sad reviews. People didn't really appreciate it and appreciate the music.
Is it based on Alice in Wonderland?
It is. Yeah. So, good job, Bugsy. It's a fun musical. It's a very fun musical. A lot of the songs are a lot of fun. So it's kind of sad that it was kind of bumped as quickly as it was, but.
Oh, that's a shame.
Yeah.
Well, looking forward to hearing Once More I Can See. Hannah, take it away.
All right.
Long ago and oh so far away, there were dreams that I recall, full of unicorns who loved to play behind my garden walls. And the clouds would look like dragon's tails as they moved across the sky. And a tree could be the Prince of Wales, little girls could fly. I remember every moment, how it was to just be me. And to my surprise, I looked through your eyes, and once more I can see. I remember living in between what is real and what is not. Neath the sky of blue and field of green, I long ago forgot. And I remember rabbits running late underneath my mother's fence, and a singing cup and talking plate who somehow both made sense. I remember every moment, I remember being free, and to my surprise, I looked at your eyes, and I remember me. For somewhere deep inside me, there's a girl from way back when. She just needs your heart to guide me and make her see again. I remember every moment how my heart was young and free, and to my surprise, I looked through your eyes, and once more, I can see.
Slow with my controls, my fingers. Awesome job, Hannah. That was beautiful.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, it's a shame. It was a flop, but you were not a flop tonight.
Oh, I appreciate that. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Hannah. We're moving on now to Brianna Galligan. And I saw Brianna earlier tonight. She was last seen hosting our Robbed Cabaret. She did an excellent job in that. And I, not that I was stalking or anything, but I saw some of the videos from the production of Phantom of the Opera that No Place Like Home Theater Company produced recently. And oh my God, what? What is happening? Those were fantastic. I'm really looking forward to seeing the, like the whole thing all together. But I saw some of the stuff in there and I'm like, what? So really excellent work with that. But Brianna, you're going to sing something from Rags.
Yes, Rags. It was a musical based around the Triangle Shirt Factory fire at the turn of the century.
Yeah.
So yeah, sadly the character who sings this song actually dies in that fire, but it's a beautiful song. And it's interesting because it's very similar to like Titanic the musical or even Ragtime and Anastasia, just with the feel of the music. So really, I don't know. I really like it. It's lovely, but barely anybody knows it anymore.
I've heard of it, but I don't know too much about it. But I'm looking forward to hearing your rendition from Rags.
Thank you very much.
Okay, we'll leave it to
perfect. Here we go.
Hiding in the wheat fields from the Cossacks and the screams. Flames are on the hillside, blood is in the streams. All the world is burning, that's the way that it seems. David, did they hurt you, darling? Show me where they hurt you, darling. Every night it fills my dreams. I see us running through the forest and there's 40 miles to go. Sneaking past the border in the silent snow. Sleeping under haystacks, eating roots where they grow. Begging on the pier at Danzig. Well, we made it here from Danzig. What's another mile or so? We're children of the wind, blown across the earth, pieces of the heart, scattered worlds apart, so far from those we love. All the children of the wind. There's a morning I want someday to see. All the children of my children are there. And they're very, very noisy, running through my kitchen. And we've been there for a lifetime. And I'll know then they will never be children of the wind, blown across the earth, half a world away. We will make our way, great ships and iron trains, cross the seas and plains, take us to the day, bring us to the shore. No more the children of the wind.
much. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Brianna.
Oh, my pleasure. Thank you.
That was awesome. So we have a little bit of a short night tonight. I'm going to turn the stage over, I believe, back to Tabitha, and she's going to kind of do a little bit of extra stuff. And then I think I'm closing out the evening.
So yeah, first of all, round of applause to everyone who performed. Thank you all so much. Honestly, I have the best time at these, no matter what. It's just amazing. Thank you all so much. And I just like wrote down a bunch of shows I want to check out and soundtracks I want to check out from songs that you guys all sang. So our next cabaret, now we're switching to once a month, and it'll always be the last week of every month. So we won't have another cabaret till the last week of October. But what was I going to say? And then the first week of every month will be trivia. But we're going to try to just change the dates around because I know some people Thursdays aren't good anymore. So I'll just try maybe 1 month it'll be on Wednesday, 1 month it'll be on a Saturday. We'll just switch it up so that people can get a chance to work with their schedule. I am not telling you guys what the theme is, but a trivia winner picked it. And no matter what the theme is, I would love to encourage costumes since it's going to be the last week of October. So we can do some kind of Halloween theme. So whatever the theme is, please feel free to wear any type of costumes. It doesn't even need to be from the show you're singing from. Any costumes are fine. So thank you, Stephen. But we do have one more amazing performance for tonight. Stephen is not only hosting, he is also performing. So take it away, Stephen.
I want to thank you, Tabitha, for giving me the opportunity to host this tonight. What a wonderful round of performances. I know tonight was a little short, but what great songs we packed in there. I'm looking at the chat and seeing the costumes. That could be dangerous. That could be really dangerous. I'm looking forward to that next cabaret at the end of October. So I'm going to be closing out the evening with a song, a Broadway flop. And originally I was going to read from like this book right here. I don't know if it's reversed. In the camera, let's put on a musical. Every performer probably already has this book. If you don't, go out and get it. There's like a million editions of this book. Originally, I was going to read from this book about the song that I was going to sing tonight. But I found out that this edition of the book does not include the musical I'm even talking about tonight. So the Broadway flop that I was going to talk about was flopped out of this very popular book. So I'll get rid of that. Actually, what I'm going to sing from tonight is from a musical called Mac and Mabel. It's about Max Sennett, the early silent movie director, and Mabel, was it? No? Oh, man, I'm terrible. Thank you. Mabel Normand, who was like the original It Girl, I think, but really big silent movie star that Max Sennett made into a silent movie star. And this was a Jerry Herman musical back at a time when Jerry Herman musicals just weren't very popular, I guess. They kind of fell out of favor after, I don't know why. I mean, Hello Dolly and Mame and all those great musicals, but for whatever reason, it just didn't do that well. It only ran 66 performances, even though it had Robert Preston and Bernadette Peters. I mean, come on, man. What the heck? But anyways, I'm gonna take a drink, a sip of water, and I'm going to sing I Won't Send Roses from Mac Mabel. Hold on, let me make sure everything is all set up here. Okay. I won't send roses or hold the door. I won't remember which dress you wore. My heart is too much in control. The lack of romance in my soul will turn you gray, kid. So stay away, kid. Forget my shoulder.
when you're in need. Forgetting birthdays is guaranteed. And should I love you, you would be the last to know. I won't send roses and roses suit you so. My pace is frantic, my temper's cross. With words romantic, I've had a loss. I'd be the first one to agree that I'm preoccupied with thee, and it's inbred, kid. Don't lose your head, kid. In me you'll find things like guts and nerve, but not the fine things that you deserve. And while there's a fighting chance, just turn and go. I won't send roses and roses suit you so.
From everyone here at No Place Like Home Theater Company, from Muggsy, and from everyone's here, thank you very much and good night.